So it was time for the round three of the Ranji Trophy. Even though the squads for the Border Gavaskar Trophy and India A has been announced, still players playing in the Ranji Trophy at this point of time would be trying for an outside chance. I know it's going to be really, really tough for most of them, but still, if they have an outstanding season, maybe not this time, going forward, it's still a long, long test season coming ahead. Maybe some player might get an opportunity. There weren't many stars participating in round three, but still there were some players who definitely caught the eye of many people. Like always in this video, I'm going to be taking you through what were the key takeaways from the third round of the Ranji Trophy. Ajinkya Rahane, skipper of the Mumbai side, did not have a great outing. He has been left out from the India circuit, even though after a disappointing test series by the Indian team, there are talks on social media that maybe you should get in Ajinkya Rahane and Chiteshwar Pujara back into the side, but both of them are not sort of helping their cause that much. Ajinkya Rahane got two innings for his side, did not score big runs, got 35 in the first innings, and 48 not out was his score in the second innings. Mumbai definitely would definitely want to defend their title this time around, but for that, Ajinkya Rahane will have to score big runs, especially in the absence of big names like Sarfaraz Khan, Mushir Khan, another person who's a big player for the Mumbai team. Shreyas Iyer wasn't around this time because of a back injury. So Ajinkya Rahane needs to do the bulk of the scoring for the Mumbai side. With him, Chiteshwar Pujara, it's the lots of people, the most chatter and the most buzz is around Chiteshwar Pujara. He also did not score big runs, did not even manage to get into double figures in both the innings, just 3 runs in the first innings and 2 runs in the second innings. So even if they want the selectors to take notice of Pujara and Rahane, for that they will have to score some big runs. Talking about big runs, it was Krunal Pandya playing for Baroda, scoring 119 runs against Orissa, also adjourned the man of the match in this game. He definitely scored 119 runs, but as far as red ball cricket is concerned, he is nowhere in the reckoning right now. If he builds up on this score moving ahead, then maybe by the end of the season, he's somebody the selectors would look at in red ball cricket as well. Rajat Patidar, the auctions are getting really, really close. The retentions are going to happen tomorrow. Then you'll see the auctions also happening later in December. But before that, he has definitely given the auctions an audition for the auctions, even though it was red ball cricket. He went on and scored 159 runs on just 102 deliveries at a strike rate of 155 and scored a total of 7 sixes. A quick fire 150 runs from Rajat Patidar. A lot of franchises will be looking at this innings of Rajat Patidar. Harshit Rana's dream run continues. First, it was him getting selected, getting his maiden call-up. It was unlucky after getting sick, wasn't able to make his debut in the T20I series. After that, was drafted in as a travelling reserve for the New Zealand side and will also be on that flight to Australia with the rest of the team for Border Gavaskar Trophy. He had a great outing against Assam, taking 5 wickets in the first innings and 2 wickets in the second inning. 7 wickets in all Harshit Rana took, and he was a key bowler for the Delhi side in the third round of the Ranji Trophy. That was all about it in the third round of the Ranji Trophy. Like I told you, not many star players performing because most of the players are either with the India team at this point of time or they have already reached Australia for the India A and Australia A series. So there's still 2 more rounds to go before we head into the white ball domestic season, the Vijay Hazare and the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy. Before that, 2 more rounds to go as far as the Ranji Trophy is concerned, and then it will resume after the white ball tournament as well. For now, the players will be wanting to enjoy the festivities at this point of time. Diwali is nearing. They would be starting their fourth round post Diwali. And then, like always, I'm going to be coming with you whatever happens in the remaining domestic season. But for now, that is it. If you haven't subscribed to Sports Today till now, do press the subscribe button. And if you like this video, do give us a like as well.